Hi everyone, welcome back to All Shinobi Channel. How are you guys? And this time the All Shinobi returns with a story that is rare and never even meet. On this occasion we will discuss 7 powers of Naruto without Kurama. Before entering the video, don't forget to like, comment and subscribe so that All Shinobi will be even more excited and will continue to update about the latest videos of Shinobi's world. Naruto is a shinobi who from childhood has been accustomed to being alone, and fights alone. Even though his life started with various trials, because he had a lack of understanding of the theory, but with the passion and hard work he had, Naruto had managed to get through all of them. Since Genin, Naruto has shown his ability by learning a technique which is actually his weakness, but because he struggled hard, he was able to master the technique overnight. During his journey with Jiraiya he had mastered Rasengan, which is a high-level technique, in 3 days, and after Jiraiya's departure, he was able to master Senjutsu Chakra in just 1 week, and also he was able to develop Senjutsu Chakra with his new technique. Initially, Naruto did not realize that he was a Jinchuriki, until Mizuki told him the truth, and his first encounter with Kurama when he fell to the bottom of a cliff. After finding out about Kurama's whereabouts, and even though it took a long time for Naruto to work with him, Naruto began to develop a technical technique that used Kurama's chakra as its base. From the chakra given by Kurama, Naruto has a variety of new abilities, such as Biju Dama, Hiraishin no Jutsu, and various other ninjutsu techniques. However, even though Naruto is without Kurama, with his achievements such as killing 2 Akatsuki members and one of them as his leader at that time, it is certain that Naruto will still be the strongest shinobi, because he has various top-level techniques. Moreover, he already has various unique abilities after he got help from the other 8 beasts during the 4th Shinobi World War. And here are 7 powers that Naruto has without the power of Kurama. 1. Perfect Sanin Mode. Sanin Mode is a technique that is only available if one has mastered Senjutsu Chakra. This is a rare technique, because it goes through several difficult processes, and carries a very high risk of losing your life. In history, only a few people can use Senjutsu and their names are included in shinobi legends, such as Hashirama, Jiraiya, Minato, Naruto and Kabuto. Senjutsu technique training also has several important requirements, such as having to have a contractual bond with the Kuchiyose animal, then having a strong bond so that the elders of the Kuchiyose animal want to teach about Senjutsu chakra, such as Naruto and Jiraiya taught by Mr. Fukusaku, and also Kabuto who taught by the White Snake Recluse. Naruto first used Sanin Mode and Chakra Senjutsu in battle, when fighting Pain, who was destroying Konoha. Only by using his Sanin Mode, he was able to defeat all 5 Pains in an instant, and destroy a Pain in just 1 hit. Currently in Konoha, only Naruto is still able to use Sanin Mode and Master of Chakra Nature, Senjutsu. And because Kurama has disappeared, of course Naruto will master the Senjutsu Chakra Fusion Mode that allows him to unite with Master Fukusaku and Mistress Shima, or other frogs. 2. Has 8 other Biju Chakras. Even though Naruto has always used chakra from Kurama, in fact, Naruto already has chakra from other beasts, during the 4th Shinobi World War, and that's the reason he can use the 6 Path Mode when fighting Madara. At that time, after Sun gave his chakra, the other beasts had given Naruto a little of their chakra when Naruto entered the dimension of the beasts, and shortly after, Obito gave Naruto chakra from Shukaku and also the Hachibi that he had absorbed from Madara before. By having the chakra of 8 other beasts, Naruto is indirectly able to use 5 basic elements. After the fight against Madara, Naruto no longer uses the other beast's chakra, besides because he doesn't want to be dependent on this chakra, Naruto also has no reason to fight using it, or in other words, no enemy forces Naruto to exert all his strength. Which he has. Naruto should rely on the strength of these Jinchuriki when he is pressed like against Ashiki, it's just that Ashiki, who is an Otsutsuki, has the ability to suck ninjutsu so it will be very useless even if Naruto exerts the power of the beasts. 3. A lot of chakra. As an Uzumaki, Naruto has inherited the blood and natural talents possessed by the Uzumaki clan, such as a lot of chakra. Kakashi said the comparison between Naruto's chakra and himself, if without Kurama's chakra or with Kurama's chakra. At that time Kakashi said, if the chakra Naruto had was 4 times more than that of a normal shinobi or Kakashi, but if it was Kurama's chakra, it could be up to 100 or even 1000 times more. With that statement, even though without Kurama the chakra that Naruto has is still very much, it is only natural that Naruto is able to project 1000 shadow clones when he is genin. With this abundance of chakra, and the various techniques he has mastered, Naruto will still be the number one shinobi in Konoha or among other villages. 4. Kekkei Genkai. Kekkei Genkai is a rare technique that is not shared by any shinobi in the shinobi world. This technique is a combination of two basic elements, such as the Mokuthon technique that comes from the earth and water release used by Captain Yamato and Hashirama, then there is ice release, which comes from wind and water releases owned by Haku and also Ryugi. And not only two elements, for some rare things, there is a Kekkei Genkai which is a combination of three basic elements, such as lava release, which is a combination of ear, fire and water release, which is owned by Four Tails Son Goku and also Mei Terumi. Or dust release, which is a combination of earth, fire and wind releases like those of Onoki and Mu. Naruto, who has chakra from other beasts, has various Kekkei Genkai such as lava release from Soak Goku, and magnet release from Shukaku. Naruto combines his Rasengan with magnetic elements to seal Madara Limbo, and uses his lava release Rasengan against Madara and Delta. 5. Rasengan Universe. The Rasengan technique was a technique that was first developed by Minato, and passed on to Naruto through Jiraiya. This is a highly difficult technique such as Chidori. Even today, the Rasengan technique is still considered dangerous, just like Aou said when he saw Boruto's Rasengan. Although Konohamaru, Boruto and Kashin Koji have the same technique, in their development, only Naruto has various variations of the Rasengan, such as Odama Rasengan, Cho Odama Rasengan, Rasen Shuriken, and many others. The use of the Rasengan which was a melee technique, where the user has to run towards the enemy to hit the enemy. Naruto has changed when he uses his Sannin mode, he can throw Rasengan energy that is very dense and mixed with wind elements, which will explode and throw thousands of fine needles that are capable of damaging the nervous system in the enemy's body, such as when facing Kakuzu or Pain. 6. Technological Science. Science tools technology is a new method of ninja fighting in the Boruto era. Initially Naruto did not agree with the development of this science technology, because it seemed very practical without having to do long enough training to master a technique. However, by looking at the development of technology that can facilitate the performance of society and shinobi, Naruto began to think openly about this technology. After Momoshiki's appearance, Dr. Katasuke, who created Naruto's prosthetic arm, began developing the ninjutsu sucking technology on the arm. Its use is very practical when compared to the one Katasuke used when on a mission to save Konohamaru. No need to create a ninjutsu ball, Naruto is able to eliminate the Rasengan that Boruto throws, and also sucks the water release Boruto uses to attack Naruto. 7. Multiple Shadow Clone. This technique is a large form of the Shadow Clone technique. If a shadow clone can have an imitation of a person's body, then multiple shadow clones are a technique that allows Naruto to create shadow clones that can create other shadow clones. This is the reason why the name is Multiple Shadow Clone. This is a technique that comes from the Forbidden Scroll that Naruto stole when he was a genin, and the greatness of this technique is, apart from the number, each shadow clone that spreads out, will give different memories depending on what they did before disappearing. Kakashi said, if Naruto did the training with 1000 shadows, then Naruto would get 1000 different experiences, and that way the training process would quickly finish in just one try. This is one of the techniques Naruto can use without having to use chakra from Kurama, such as when beating Mizuki, training in Yamato's waterfall, or to withstand attacks from Pain Akatsuki. And it is not impossible, with Kurama's disappearance, Naruto, who feels that he has lacked his fighting strength, will train various techniques, such as the Hiraishin no Jutsu, such as when he managed to get through the Raikage, who even felt that Naruto had surpassed Minato's speed at that time. Enough to get here first all shinobi this time? If there is a request to discuss anything about the world of shinobi, please write in the comments, and all shinobi will try to explain it, as interesting as possible. For the next story, don't forget to like, comment and subscribe, because all shinobi still has lots of stories and theories about the world of shinobi of course. See you next time, and goodbye.